on the group.
Inshallah, let's have the entire presentation share.
Yes, the presentation is clear now, the PowerPoint.
Okay. Okay, we are students of semantics and lexicology course. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This is our second live lecture in this semester. In this lecture, we are going to talk about key terms and lexicology and lexicography. We have three files to discuss in this lecture. Before starting the discussion, if you have any question related to what we did last time, so please let me know. So last time was an overview of the course. So if you have any question, please let me know.
Hello, doctor. This is my first lecture. I attend the last lecture. I wasn't, and I switched from another major, which
you are
business administration.
You are welcome, but please, those who just joined our program or our course, still they need to go back to what we did earlier. So we have a Facebook group, we have a WhatsApp group, we have the Moodle. There are different messages posted. So please read and study and follow the instructions.
And there is assignment
in the different means of communication for this course. So please, you are welcome, but still you are responsible for what you have missed so far. أهلا وسهلا عمر, أهلا وسهلا أمل, أهلا وسهلا بالجميع. Those who have problems, please let me know. But so far we haven't discussed a lot of stuff. But what we have done so far is still your responsibility to know. Whether you joined us just recently or you, for a reason, you didn't attend last class, or you didn't check the WhatsApp or Facebook or the Moodle. So you are responsible for what we do in our lectures and what we do or what we post in the Facebook, Moodle, and so on. So please, I sent you an assignment which is due this week in the on Thursday. So you need to follow the instructions of this assignment. It's a summary of a chapter. I sent you a chapter. It's from a book by Edward Finnegan, Language, Its Structure and Use. You need to read this, the chapter and summarize it in just 600 to 700 words. Within academic writing guidelines, essay writing format. One important point about this assignment is, so some instructions are posted in the Moodle. So I recommend you check this file, the guidelines, the details of the assignment. Important points to highlight, موجود. So the font, the size of the font type, the size of the font, also accurate word count. مش صعبة الناس اللي لسه بتتعلم. كلنا بنتعلم. Highlight your text, and you can find the number of words in the bottom of your Microsoft Word program. بتحط الرقم so the accurate word count. عدد كلماتك وكلماتك اللي انت لخصت فيهم. So the summary must be between or within this number of words, 600 to 700 words. In essay format, ضروري essay format, paragraphs. The writer discusses so and so. So you need to give me in the bottom of your summary the number of the words that your summary has. Also, you need to edit for your summary for free.
Dr. Hassan.
Pardon.
Dr. Hassan. Pardon. Some students are in the waiting room. Will you please just admit them?
Great. Okay. So here one. Another two. More. المفروض عملت automatic admittance. You are welcome. أهلا وسهلا بالحضور الجميع. الآن عندنا 27 طالبة وطالب. أشكركم جميعا. So back to this. This idea of so the summary which is due on Thursday. الناس اللي ما شفتش check the model. The guidelines for this summary are in this file of assignment 1 chapter summary. Important points to highlight. Edit your summary carefully for grammar, spelling and or punctuation errors. مسؤوليتك ومسؤوليتك تكوني كاتبة يعني well organized and error free as much as you can. So,
Doctor, I think 700 is a small number of words. I think we are gonna miss a lot of information.
A summary doesn't need each and every detail in the chapter. When you write, for example, an abstract for an article or your thesis or whatever, when you are assigned this guideline or protocol, write up an abstract within, let's say, 150 words or 200 words. So you need to follow the instructions. Of course, you would leave some details. I understand this. But again, try to highlight the important points.
Leave the okay, outlines.
Leave the list important ones. وأكيد يعني الكل عارف. One important point, very, very important point, maybe the most important one, is to adhere to the ethics of research writing or scientific research. الناس يعني احنا الآن باحثين وطلبة ماجستير وضروري نلتزم بأخلاقيات البحث العلمي. أنا بحاسب طلاب البكالوريوس, so those who are in my BA program, so my BA students, are penalized or punished just for copying and pasting without documenting or not following or adhering the ethics of research. وعند الطرق, I have the ways or the means to tell who has plagiarized and where he or she has admit. Okay. طيب ايش الدعوة؟ تمام. اوكي, سو بليز وين يو دوكيومنت, وين يو سمرايز, اور وين يو رايت ا بيس اوف رايتنج ان اكاديميك رايتنج, يو نيد تو فولو ذا ايثكس اوف ريسيرش. يو كان كوبي اند بيست وذ ا كوتيشن مارك اور جاست the text given with the page number, but not within beyond the 20% of copying and pasting. مسموح لك ولك 20% quoting the writer or the author. But again, try to minimize quotation or quoting. So copying and pasting. ضروري ان تلتزم بالتعليمات. طبعا حاجه مهمه, your name in Arabic with this assignment number and angle 6321 in a PDF file. لازم الجميع يسلم. So don't miss this deadline. 1 PM Thursday, October 1st. معاك أنا بعته من حوالي 3-4 days ago. But still you have a couple of days more. So please, procrastination, as I said before, procrastination is a disease. هذا تسويف مرض. يا ريت نلتزم ونحاول نستغل الوقت أو نستثمر الوقت. 1 p.m. For October 1st in the Moodle. Don't send me this assignment via email or via WhatsApp or via Facebook. So via the Moodle in the folder. والناس اللي لسه ما سجلتش, those who haven't registered or solved their university or admission problems, please do it as soon as possible. والحمد لله يعني الامور بدات تبشر بخير يعني, وان شاء الله الخير ده قادم واقدم والجم والقادم اجمل. ابتداء من بكره, from tomorrow حيكون we have like يعني دوام في الجامعه الاسلاميه. الدوائر والعمادات هتشتغل طبيعي, يمكن دوام جزئي من 9 ل 2, but if you have a problem you can go there, get copies of material, bookstores there, ask about problems that you have, solve them, fix them. So again, inshallah, it's your responsibility to follow and work. And I recommend you work hard. And those who work hard will reap the fruit. أكيد هنقطف الثمرة إن شاء الله, والكل يكون يعني to have something enjoyable إن شاء الله. التعليمات كالتالي, الاسم بالعربية تحت زي ما انت شايف هنا, and assignment 1 وانجل 6321. الجميع التزم التعليمات هذه, يا ريت عشان يسهل علي الشغل والمتابعه واعطيكم فيدباك, to give you some feedback ان شاء الله. Don't worry, احنا بنتعلم وجايين هنا نشتغل مع بعض ونتفاهم على امور, وان شاء الله نوصل لخير ان شاء الله. So please follow instructions, واهم شيء when you do an exercise, when you do an activity, you need to understand the instructions of an activity, of the activity. Without understanding the instructions or guidelines, you will do something different and you will lose marks. And I would like to talk about an experience, a bad experience with one of my friends when I was in my 10th grade, في الصف عشر ابتدائي, عاشر, أولى ثانوي. I remember this still experience with one of my friends, Basim, one of the top students in the school. He was sitting with me in my in the exam hall of the history subject, the final exam. And he left happily. He left the exam hall happily, and after a couple of minutes, he returned crying. رجع يبكي. Teacher asking the observer, begging him to return this his sheet to him. No way, Basim, crying. I have missed a whole question, teacher, please. Big problem. One of the top students, Basim, how come? The question, the instructions, the exam guidelines were as follows. So answer, أجب عن ثلاثة أسئلة على أن يكون الأول منها. Tricky, still you need to follow instructions. تعليمات لازم نلتزم فيها ونتبعها, وإلا هنخسر حاجات. مسكين باسم. Poor Basim, he left a whole question. He answered second, third and fourth question, but not the one that was inclusive, كان مطلوب and a must. Okay, so please follow instructions. That's enough about the summary. Any question before moving to the discussion of the files I sent you? Questions, guys?
Yeah.
أنا عندي 33 طالب وطالبة. جميل, شيء طيب. تفضل, في أحد عنده سؤال؟ Okay, let's start with the third file. It's just one sheet. طبعا بالمناسبة, I sent you the files electronically. You can study them from your mobile or your laptop. It's okay, but some students كنت بتوصل مع أحد الطلاب زميلكم أقول أنا رايح المكتبة عشان أصور الأوراق الملفات اللي أنت بعتهم. To have a hard copy is fine. I myself have hard copies of the file I sent you. وهي هنا يعني موجود. So it's useful, but not obligatory. Not obligatory. Okay. So what do we mean by this expression word? It's one page, but it is a nice file or a nice handout. Some points to ponder. خلينا نسأل. Is it always easy to say what a word is?
No.
No, it's not.
No.
أنا معي أسماء طلاب وطالبات المجموعة المساق يعني مش غلط يعني okay so it's not so لكن السؤال بيكمل why مش كافي بس يعني to say no it's not always easy to why or why not why يا ده شو الجواب ده السؤال
The word can divided in more than one categories. It can be verb, noun, adjective, adverb. You have to explain.
But in your material, there is a simple answer to this question.
There's a morphological and lexical word and semantic words also, and orthographic words also.
So we have different approaches to defining.
So
we can answer this question by saying that we don't have, as your material says, we don't have a totally satisfactory
definition.
So we have different definitions. But a single definition is not totally satisfactory. ليس لا يوجد تعريف مرضي وبطريقة كافية جدا. A totally satisfactory definition. That's why we say it is not always easy to say what a word is. خلينا نشوف مثال جميل. Let's have this word in Arabic from Hud chapter in the Quran. Chapter
أنلزمكموها.
Okay. So is this one word?
Yes.
Okay, one word. So what do you mean by one word? And if we want to translate it into English, can we have just one word as equivalent to this word?
One sentence.
In fact, we have seven words, not just one word in English. So, shall we compel you to accept it? Please, switch your mic off, please, when it's not necessary. Please turn your mic off. الكل شايف ال word program?
Yes.
Yes.
نشوف الكلام اللي حي. Anti. This
establishmentarianism.
Anti-disestablishmentarianism.
Okay, so
I guess this word is meaning of this word is الانشقاقيين. This has a historical meaning.
So this is one word in English.
Yes, 27 letters. So anti-disestablishmentarianism. Can I explain it?
So how to translate it into Arabic first? Who can translate
it? Can I explain it, doctor? Can I explain it?
My question is, it's equivalent in Arabic.
الانشقاقيين.
لا مش انشقاقيين.
مبدأ التخريب, I think. مبدأ التخريب.
هو.
I have a story. I have the historical meaning of this word.
يا معارضة
yes, I have the historical story. Can I say it?
Go ahead.
Before centuries, there's a conflict between the church and the scientific people. The church want to control everything in the country, but there's a lot of people want to make the science is the control of everything. So they create a group of people called disestablish. So the church came with a new word, it anti-disestablishment. Then one of the, one of them add affix or suffix, and then the other add a affix or suffix to mean anti-establishmentarianism, to mean معارضة الانشقاق.
لكن لو بدنا نترجمها للعربية الآن هنقول حركة الموالاة للكنيسة. وطبعا ممكن نقول الكنيسة الرسمية أو كنيسة ال يعني. So this is one word in English. But we have at least three or four words in Arabic to give it its equivalent. So again, it's not easy to say what a word is. It's not always easy. Okay. Now a statement. A word can occur in isolation. What do you think?
Yes, sometimes
okay.
as utterance.
Yes, a word can isolate all of the most frequently implied meaning, orthographic word, a morphological word, lexical word, and semantic word.
No, so now when we say in isolation, what does this mean? So it is fine. So to say that some words are in isolation. A word like
alone.
Oh, please.
You can stand alone or give a meaning, a clear meaning.
The word that, or the word my, or the word a.
Sometimes it can.
Not always.
Sometimes it can appear alone.
Great.
But not always.
Not all. Some words like these, the terminals, so this, for example, and so on.
Yeah.
Always.
Cannot stand.
In phrases. So not used in isolation as a separate words. So.
It depends on the meaning of the words.
Closed words. Words can stand alone.
Car, the word boy, the word room, the word Mona Hassan can appear, but not all of them. Okay. Please turn off your mic. Bit of meaning. What do you think?
Yes, doctor.
Yes,
the word contains one meaning. That's right, because there is a core of the meaning of the word. There is a core, and the core holds the all meaning of the word.
So I have some girls here. I ask Reem Al Masri. Is Reem present? Reem, can you answer?
Yes,
question?
Yes, doctor. What? I'm here.
Go ahead, Reem. So a word contains one unit of meaning. What do you think?
I don't think so. A word, some words are cannot give meaning or indicate
any meaning without being attached to morphemes or suffix or prefix, like a doesn't indicate any meaning, I think, without being attached to another word.
So when we say one unit of meaning, the file, this handout means component, a component of meaning, one single component of meaning. But according to the material I sent you, this is not true about all words in the in language. So we can sometimes find different components of meanings in one word. So we have in the material the word cow. So we have different components of meaning in the word cow. So we can say that it is a noun, and it is a bovine or related to bovine facility of car.
It's a familiar.
So we have now different semantic units or meaning units or components of meaning in one word. So to say a word contains one or consists of one unit of meaning is not true regarding most words in language. Some maybe have one unit of meaning, but most words can be analyzed and thought of as having different components of meaning. Now, your material gives this diagram. We have cow, we have bull, and we have calf. Now, 3-4 minutes, I want you to do this activity. Establish similar patterns for the second set of words given in the handout. The second set of words are these three red words in the presentation. Can you see the slide? الجميع شايف the slide?
Yes, clear.
Great. Now, I would like you to do this activity in a draft notebook على ورقة خارجية كده, ونرجع مع بعض بعد دقائق ثلاثة كده to discuss your answer. But I'd like also you to check a dictionary. You may need a dictionary for the pronunciation of a word, for the meaning of a word, in order to give now this diagram, the diagram that you have in the slide or you have in your material. Cow with the three components of meaning, ball with the three components of meaning, and calf with three components of meaning, and so on. We are coming to this idea later in the semester or in the course about semantic features and semantic properties, but let's follow this pattern, or let's say this example. So cow, ball, and calf are analyzed as having more than one component of meaning or unit of meaning, and we need now to do the same. 2-3 minutes, and we are returning. When حسكر السم ال ال الكاميرا عشان أشرب مية كده ولا okay.
بدنا الشاشة عشان نحل
مستر السلايد أيوة تمام
خلاص تمام
you have the words in the material. The material has these words. I am just I copied and pasted. So establish similar patterns for the second set of words. The two sets of words are in the material, cow, bull, calf, and the three words that I highlighted in red. One more minute. كمان دقيقة. And we are gonna discuss your answers. Okay. Anybody? I can call names.
So let's say guess oxen. Oxen, yes. Doctor. What about the word oxen?
Before.
Yes, doctor.
Before answering or doing this activity or taking your answer to this activity, I'd like to know whether you know how to pronounce the words.
Yes, doctor.
Yes, doctor.
So who can read? Who can read the first word? Omar Salah?
Yes.
Yes, doctor.
The first one is you.
You.
Omar Salah?
Yes, yeah.
Can you read the first word?
Sorry, but I didn't understand the question clearly.
So the pronunciation.
Cow.
The pronunciation. Oh. Sorry. The red ones. The red ones.
The red. Ram, lamb.
First word is
you, not you.
You. Is it you? Five. Hatistagrif, Minkum. Can you see now my word here, this one?
Yeah.
Yes. Pronounced the same.
This is the transcription.
Yeah.
The transcription of the pronoun, please, and the word E-W-E, this is how to transcribe the word. So now, this is you. Before is, please, turn off. Your mic, please. Turn off your mic, please. Now, this word, these two words can be considered as homophones. Later, we are coming to this idea or concept of homophony. Two words spelled differently, but pronounced alike. So, the E-W-E is U or IU. Before going back to the activity, I'd like to talk about something that I feel from experience. I feel to be a very important thing, which is the difference between A and N as indefinite articles in English. Now, هتقول هذا كلام مش مطلوب مني. وأنا semantics and lexicology course, things are overlapping, guys. And I feel from experience, and most of you are teachers, I feel that this is something very important. Now, when we teach A and N as indefinite articles, most of teachers are referred to the vowel letters A, E, I, O, and U.
Yes.
But from experience, I, as a teacher of English, I feel that it is better to focus on sounds rather than letters. So sometimes, ايش معنى الكلام هذا يا دكتور يا أبو أحمد. Now sometimes. طبعاً هنا سوري هذه اي زي خواتها و Okay. Sometimes a vowel letter, فأنا بتكلم كده, a vowel letter is a consonant sound. A consonant sound. كيف يعني؟ أجمل مثال اللي موجود فوق. إحنا الآن هنقول واحد عنده what is a you. الآن إحنا عرفنا لفظ you. What is a you؟ الناس اللي دورت في القاموس ماذا تعني you؟
It is a female sheep.
It is a female
sheep.
Female sheep يعني نعجة.
نعجة.
أبو محمد جارنا عنده نعجة. لديه حيوانات أعزكم الله في المزرعة بتاعته ومن ضمنهم نعجة. He has a you or a new. He has a you or a new.
A new.
What does this mean? Now this vowel letter is not a vowel sound. It is a consonant sound.
Yeah. So depending on the pronunciation.
مثال تاني. I am, واحد بيقول, a university student. Or Islamic University of Gaza is a university or an academic institution. Also a university, a university. So I will he goes to a university in the USA or in Gaza. So we say now university with A, not N. Although we have an apple and we have an uncle, an umbrella, and so on, but again, وصلنا لفكرة إنه sometimes a vowel letter is not a vowel sound. It can be a consonant sound.
Can I say something, doctor?
Go ahead.
Regarding the same thing, in the other hand, a word like our, a word like honest, also start with a consonant letter. Yet when we use it in a sentence, we say he is an honest man.
He waited for an hour. Why now have an hour? Because again, we are concerned with pronunciation. This word starts with a vowel sound. Got it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
ممكن something not totally related, but I feel it's important. So you is a female sheep, and it starts with a consonant sound. وطبعا نقيس على كده ممكن نقول يورو دينار دولار. So a dinar, a dollar, a pound. So we can say a euro or a European country and so on. Okay, so who can now establish similar patterns? So let's go to Sabrine Gishtad. Sabrine Gishtad. Can you hear me, Sabrine? Is Sabrine present? Guys, موجودة Sabrine معنا؟ Okay. Sabrine. Okay, Ghada, Ghada Rosli. Ghada Rosli.
Yes, doctor.
Go ahead, Ghada. Now.
Yes.
So, خلينا نشوف نفس الباتر. Now we can put you.
Sorry. Yes, you is a noun.
A noun with a plus. And أخذ بالنا من فكرة plus. With them, يعني later we are going to have pluses and minuses. إشارة الزايد وإشارة الناقص. الكتاب اللي أو الماتيريال اللي إحنا موجودة this handout uses pluses. Later we are going to have like a better notation. Plus versus minus. So plus noun.
Plus female.
Plus what? يعني حاجة مفقودة. يعني اتفقنا إنه bovine بخصوص ال cow bovine معناتها related to إذا من فصيلة الأبقار.
Sheep are related to ovine.
إذا برضو
adjective.
You yes. is related to plus sheep هنا. هنكتب هنا
plus sheep.
Plus sheep.
Sheep.
Yes. الماعز أو لا لا. So.
Plus.
And plus female. Plus.
Plus female.
Now ram. Yes. Ram is a plus noun. أيوة يا غادة. Plus noun.
Plus sheep.
Yes.
Plus sheep.
Plus sheep.
Plus
male.
Plus sheep.
Not bovine.
Plus male.
Not plus bovine. Sorry.
Plus male.
يا أستاذة.
Yes.
Bovine. ال
sheep.
So yes. Plus sheep. And the plus male.
Plus sheep. Plus male.
Plus male.
Yes.
Plus male. And we have. إذا تاخذي بالك في عندك umbrella sheep and we have two different genders or sexes you and ram okay and we have now this neutral neutral
yes.
The
lamb plus noun
plus
sheep
plus sheep
plus unmarked sex
okay great and now you need to know how to pronounce this last word L A M B This letter, the last letter is
silent.
Not, is silent.
Silent.
ساكنة لا تلفظ. So we, وطبعا جون دان له قصيدة the tiger وقصيدة أخرى the lamb.
Yeah. The tiger and the lamb.
Okay. Question. Who has a question, guys? في حد عنده سؤال؟
No, doctor, everything clear.
Okay, doctor.
Thank you.
Let's may I say something?
Okay, go ahead. If you have a question, a point to comment, something to say, go ahead. تفضل يا أستاذ اللي رفع إيده عماد أو عماد الدين. Who would like to speak? Go ahead.
Now you is female, ram is male, and lamb is unmarked sex?
Yes, so you is a female, and ram is male, and lamb is unmarked sex. حسب الترتيب اللي شفتيه فوق. So you have now this pattern, the same pattern بدا نفس القالب نشكله. نفس النموذج اللي موجود فوق. اسم من فصيلة الأبقار وأنثى كاو. And so on. So you is a noun, and it is related to sheep, and you is a female, and so on. With it, clear?
Yes, but I have a comment, please.
Why comment?
Why? So what is the purpose of this activity? Okay, we know that the O is female, the U is female, the male and ram is a female. So what is the purpose of this?
Wonderful question. سؤال رائع. You remember this point? A word contains one unit of meaning, and we disagreed with this statement.
Exactly.
So now,
when
we talk about now semantics, we are going now to talk about components of meanings or units of meaning in maybe in one word or one lexical
item
or in vocabulary item and so on. So we are analyzing now, we are analyzing words, we are analyzing let's say items in language or vocabulary items in language with reference to units of meaning. And we can talk about now semantic properties or semantic features, which is something that we are going to discuss in more details later. Thank you. It's a wonderful question.
May I ask another question?
Go ahead. Is that we learned that you is a word in the dictionary, and it's a word in your lexicon, the mental dictionary. But now, what is it? In your mental dictionary, you store, so this is mental, this is a mental storage of vocabulary or liquor, but you store different components of meaning about each and every word. So, لو سألتك بالعربي الآن ما ماذا تعرف عن كلمة نعجة؟
It has different sets of meaning.
هي اسم تستعمل في اللغة كاسم وهي من فصيلة ال هي حيوان من فصيلة ولا المعز لا مش الأبقار
المعز
and وأنثى وهكذا yeah. So you got now different components or units of meaning just about one word, and we can go further and explain or see other patterns with different sets and so on. But it's just an activity, and I like your question very much. اللي سأل أشكرك جدا على السؤال. Wonderful question. More comments يا جماعة إذا عندك أي سؤال بدك جلش. الناس بيقول لك لا لا سؤال تافه لا لا I like it very much. A wonderful question.
Okay دكتور.
تفضل.
We said that you is a female. Plus female, plus noun, plus sheep. I believe there is another word for sheep. We can say it's ovine. Like bovine for cows, it's ovine for sheep.
So this is a piece of information that I need to check. Thank you for this comment. But again, we can go further. So we can go further and add more units of meaning to this word. So not just ثلاثة هدول اسم وهي من الماعز وهي أنثى. طب ما ممكن يقول كمان وشعر وجلد وأربع رجلين وودان without and so on. So we have different components of meaning to describe what we mean by a ewe or what we mean by a ram and what we mean by a lamb and so on. وطبعا لما يضحي الانسان بيقول لك هذا لسه ما بلغش سنه وما ينفعش يضحي بيه. So you can see how language works and how semantics is important to learn when we learn language and know language.
But
ovine
is adjective, it's not a noun, yeah, it's adjective ovine.
Okay, but this idea of Bovine is related to, it's an adjective, that's right. So a piece of information,
it's a noun,
I love your point, I love your comments. Thank you very much. So, feel free to ask about anything you don't understand.
I guess about the question, doctor.
Let's say to enrich our discussion. مشاركتك ومشاركتك تثري اللقاء وأنا أشكر الجميع على هكذا يعني إثراء المحاضرة.
دكتور
تفضل.
I guess this activity or this kinds of the division of the words belongs to the first tries to make dictionaries. When they want to make dictionaries at the beginning, they tries to classify words into groups or categories, and this is the first try to make it.
In fact, this is also another point, which is a wonderful comment. هنسمع ونشوف كلمة lexicography. Lexicography اللي هي dictionary making, اللي هي file 2 اللي أنا بعت لكم إياه. على بدينا file 3 رغم إنه التسلسل كلام. file one definition, file two lexicology and lexicography, and file three what do you mean by word. But then file three. But I like this point: dictionary making, lexicography. How dictionarists make dictionaries or lexicographics. اللي هم الناس اللي يعني بيعملوا قواميس. And we have difference between lexicology and lexicography. Because lexicology is like a system. And you know the relationship among words in your mental dictionary or in your lexicon, like antonymy, synonymy, homonymy, and so on. When we talk about dictionary, we talk about now how alphabet and how, so what to include in a dictionary. This is something interesting, and we may discuss it in later, inshallah, today in our second file, which I sent you. Great, great discussion. I like it very much. Thank you all for this
excuse me, doctor.
Question.
Excuse me, doctor.
Go ahead.
Can we say cattle instead of sheep? Cattle instead of sheep?
I guess no, doctor. Can I answer? Because no. Cattle have the meaning, has the meaning of a group of one, a group of one, not one.
So cotton,
like sheep.
So cotton is something that is material, and we can think of cotton as a noun, and we can have it like a. ممكن نعمل انا بتخيل انه ممكن في داخل دماغك in your mental dictionary you know that cotton is a noun, cotton is plus concrete, not abstract, cotton is like a material, cotton has its color, so we can again study semantic
I mean كتل دكتور كتل ماشية
كتل كتل C-A-T-L-E كتل ممكن يعني but كتل is like يعني برودر كتل is برودر الماشية هي أكثر من شغلة so not just sheep ماشية فصيلة الماعز ممكن يكون حاجات أخرى يعني we can go further and study what are now the subcategories or sub classes of cattle? C A double T L E. That's right. Thank you very much. Yes. So with Halina Aktoban, cattle. Zamir Kumbis this word. Cattle.
Yes.
Ilmashia. وتمام وطبعا ممكن take a dictionary and see exactly what a cattle means and what cattle means and how to analyze it into its meaning units or components of meaning. Wonderful guys, thank you very much. Let's move on. So now discuss four different approaches toward meaning. In this simple handout, واخذت معظم المحاضرة اليوم معلش مش غلط لكن I like the discussion. And in university work, we have the flexibility in what and the flexibility in how. And I'm concerned about how, the quality. So if you have a problem, we can go back to things that are not clear. And it's okay to leave some stuff that we cannot cover in this semester. So, but again, you need to work on your own, something that you can have as self-study, but so far, so good, I think. Discuss four different approaches to meaning. Now, what are they? لو سألت الأخ منصور منصور الملالحة
يا دكتور I'm here
go ahead now tell me the four approaches toward meaning in your material in this handout
I'm trying to think about that
كتابك معاك المفروض ورقتك معاك.
Let me talk دكتور. I am بدرية أبو طه.
أوكي. بدرية مطوعة. بدرية جمال أبو طه. قاعد بدرية.
Yes, there are four approaches to the word. The first one, an orthographic word, is one which has, orthographic word is one which has a space on either side of it. It concentrates on the written media. The second one.
Okay, that's right. So one approach to defining meaning of a word is this orthographic approach, orthographic word. So to discuss it orthographically or to view it as like a grapheme, something that is written,
written form
with a space on either side. Now, if you look at this now, at this slide, الموجود عندك إقبالك هنا, we have a slide with now 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 words. Now with again with spaces on either side. كلمة four لها على جانبها فراغ قبلها بعدها different discuss four points ponder two. So each word has a space when it is written. وهذا الكلام يا إخوان يعني كلام رائع وكلام مهم. It's important to think of language as having two mediums. One is speech and the other is writing or written form. Now, sometimes people by mistake don't leave a space. خلينا نخرج عن النقطة هذه وبعدين نرجع لبقية الموضوع يا بدرية والجميع. لكن سألت الآن معلش الأمور ممكن تقول يعني not relevant. But I feel it is very relevant. Let's just think of now this. So what's now the difference between these two forms? خلينا نقول الأزرق.
Can I answer?
خلينا بس شوية كده. ولا الأسود. الكل شايف؟
Yes, clear.
Yes, doctor.
By the orthographic approach, the first maybe is one word, the second is two. Or you mean the meaning?
The meaning is. Can I answer, doctor?
أنا كلام جميل. But now we need to think of something very important. Now,
yes, can answer.
السؤال الآن. Both are orthographic words. We have orthographic words. Now,
the first one is adverb.
Yes, doctor.
The second is an verb phrase.
How many orthographic words? This is one. One.
The first one, the second
one. And we have. This is two. And this is three. So we have three orthographic words.
Yeah.
طيب الآن سؤالي. Which is right, which is wrong? Right.
There is no right, no wrong. Both of them have a specific meaning. One of them maybe as one word, maybe as adverb. Here is mean possibly, perhaps. But as two words, it is a verb phrase, not adverb.
شكرا بس يا ريت برضو خلينا انا عشان برضو اربط النقاط مناقشه هنادي على اسماء وممكن يكون دورك او دور غيرك. Maybe is a word that is used in English, so it's correct. And may is also a word, and me is also a word. So we can sometimes leave a space and have two words. And sometimes, please turn off your mic. المايك مسكر يا ريت. Maybe is one word without a space, and now it has a different function without a space. It is an adverb, and it means perhaps. But maybe with a space, two orthographic words, This means that we have now me as a word and me as a word with a space on either side. Now me is an auxiliary verb and be is also an auxiliary verb. So me is a modal verb and be is a verb to be. And we can change be into may go, may come, may visit, may leave. So you understand now both are fine, both are correct, but sometimes it's incorrect. So في ناس يا جماعة وانت ممكن اللي عنده خلفة واللي عنده أولاد أو الطفل ممكن تلاقي مشكلة في أطفال بيروحوا البيت ينسخوا وبتلاقي أبن وعمود كده كولم وينسخ يا ولد أبن أكاد وهكذا. Is this an English word? Is this a...
No.
Oh, no,
it is not English word.
Is this an orthographic word?
No.
Not at all.
So sometimes when we leave a space, we get two different meanings from where, the other way, not leaving a space. Sometimes when we don't leave a space, the result is now a problem in correct form. So a pen. Even in the biggest English dictionary, ولا في أكبر قواميس اللغة الإنجليزية موجود الكلام هذا A P E N. So we need to leave a space, a pen. عشان كده يا جماعة في الفيس أحيانا في ناس بتكتب أو بتكتب هكذا. خلينا نكتب عربي وبيكتب هيك. هذا موجود الكلام؟
انا بكتب هيك.
It's totally wrong.
لغويا
ان شاء الله هي تعني انشاء بناء.
لغويا linguistically or let's say syntactically هذا الكلام مش غلط. وفاكرين كلمة المرة الماضية لما قلنا colorless
green.
So,
syntactically,
this is fine. But semantically, come on, So, inshallah, we have a problem هنا. إنشاء وكأنه إنشاء بمعنى خلق. وبنخرج من الملة يا جماعة. التوي اللي أختي قالت أنا بعمل. If you do it intentionally, اللي بيعمل الكلام هذا متعمد.
أول مرة أرى.
اللي بيعمل الكلام هذا متعمد يخرج من الملة. So إن شاء
الله.
أنت خذ بالك. إن شاء الله three orthographic words. Got my point? So sometimes we have a problem. Sometimes we have two different functions. So like for example here, when we have no space, it's wrong. Maybe with a space has different meaning from no space. Maybe without a space. Inshallah, with a space has a different meaning from inshallah without a space and so on. كلام طويل لكن وصلت الرسالة. شكرا.
Can I give an example, please?
We have too many examples. احنا مش هنخلص اليوم. انا يعني لو انا عاوز محاضرة من 3 ساعات مش هخلص. But I like يعني so this point. اذا لو انا مدرس مدرسة ابتدائي او غيره او ابنك او بنتك في او ابنك او بنتك تقول الابله قالت هيك والابله كتبت هيك وده بذكرني في احمد اليوم احمد ابنه 30 سنه وان شاء الله كمان كم يوم بيناقش الدكتوراه الماجستير وان شاء الله الدكتوراه عقبال انكم يوم بيروح من الروضه coming home from the kindergarten when What did you do at the kindergarten, Ahmed? كان عمره 5 سنوات. 5 years old. We learned some English words. تعلمنا شوية كلمات إنجليزي. Like what? Apple, banana, orange, he said. Yeah, Baba, I said to him. Orange. And he said, orange. So I corrected him again, Ahmed, orange. And he repeated, orange. Ya Baba, isma kwayz. Orange. So he said, orange, jalabla alitik. You see now the point. Teach students copy their teachers or imitate. Jalabla alitik, shu bifahmak inta wala shu bi'arifak inta. So again, so you are teachers at school or later shala university. So you would find some students copy and imitate. So please be a good model. Be a good example. Thank you. Is an affirm with a space. Yeah, khawat, ya ulad, as a column. Sahih, this is different from Arabic. We don't have it with an equivalent in Arabic. Affirm column. Please turn off your mic. Now, the second approach, وخلينا نشوف معنا فاتن حسين. فاتن منير. The second approach.
Yes, doctor.
فاتن معايا؟
No, عبير.
عاوز فاتن حسين، فاتن منير حسين. No, فداء ثابت، فداء.
Can I answer, doctor?
طيب رشا الهمس.
Yes, doctor. Yes, doctor.
يا جماعة
yes, doctor. Yes, I'm here.
مين رشا الهمس؟
Yes.
Yes, doctor, I'm
Fida.
Yes, I'm Rasha. The second
of خلينا نرجع لفداء. خلينا نرجع لفداء. شوف فداء. تنعلم لفداء شاركة. The second approach.
The second approach, a morphological word, is a unique form. It considers form only without meaning.
So the morphological pattern, and we can have examples. We can have examples. So now, when we see, sometimes we have two words with the same spelling. So morphologically, as a morphological word, so we have now this. So be careful. So morphological approach to words. Now, the third approach.
The third approach.
Yes, doctor. Yes, I'm here. The third approach is a lexical word, comprehends the various form of items which are closely related by meaning.
Like, so we have, sometimes you may find this word in some books or references, a technical term, lexeme. Lexeme. Turn off your so lexeme. So lexeme is a technical term. So it could be like an umbrella for different forms. So the word, for example, go, went, goes, going, gun. They have the same lexeme, or they belong to the same lexeme. So when we talk about now the lexical approach or toward meaning, we can say that these
one lexical word.
One lexical word, according to the material, one lexical word. But
they are quite morphological words.
But morphologically, so they are different. So when we talk about now, so orthographically, they are, so we have five. حسب ما أنت شايف يعني كل كلمة على يمينها فراغ وعلى شمالها فراغ. إذا حسب الكتابة orthographically we have five. Morphologically we have five. Now lexically we have one. حسب التعريف في الكتاب أو الملزمة أو الهاند أوت. So they belong to one lexical category or one lexeme. So وعادة بيكتبوها كابيتال لتر جو So these five words belong to one lexeme, G-O, go. That my point?
Yeah.
Now the last approach toward meaning is the semantic approach. طبعاً يمكن بعض some references may talk about or discuss this stuff in different ways or different approaches. Now, four different approaches toward meaning: orthographic approach, morphological approach, lexical approach, and now semantic approach. Now, semantic approach, we have now a word with its meaning, which is with its semantic components or meaning components. التصدف في الكتاب موجود عندك بعض الأمثلة كلمات the same form, the same letters with different meanings. Like for example, the word bank. Now, if for example, we have now the word bank, we have two different now. So we can consider so financial institution
the and other one is an edge of a river.
How much funds is it called? How much funds
is the side of a river? Now, according to this material or handout we have, now bank and bank are two different semantic words. But in terms of morphology, we have now. What?
This is a homograph.
It's called homophones, doctor, isn't it? Homophones.
Homograph.
لا هو
homograph or homograph.
أنا شوف له.
No.
It's polysemy. Polysemy. في حاجة اسمها polysemy أو homonymy. أنا أعرف الفرق. هذا الموضوع موضوع homonymy وليس polysemy. Homonymy. Polysemy meaning is related, but homonymy different meanings. هنشوف الكلام. يعني لو أنا قلت لك مثلاً foot. تكون قمة يعني رجل قدم وممكن foot of a mountain هدول بيكون معنيين ولكن related in a way or another this is polysemy. هنشوفه قدام إن شاء الله. So now these are the four approaches toward meaning. خلينا نشوف activity على سريع قد سرقنا لكن I like the discussion. يمكن قبل activity هذه نأخذ استراحة خمس دقائق في المكان ممكن نقف ونعمل رياضة physical education يعني نشرب مية أنا هسكر الكاميرا ثلاث أربع دقائق مش هقدر أسكر التسجيل عشان ما أقطعش الفيديو لما نبعته مرة واحدة ممكن خلينا نقول 2 minutes ونعمل كده رياضة في المكان تفضل أنت وإنتي ويا ريت عشان برضه اخد نفس واشرب ميه هات يا طلال ميه
خلينا الاكتيفيتي
سيبونا من الاكتيفيتي لا
عشان نفكر
اوكي والعودة احمد ان شاء الله the activity now you have a list of words I'd like you to tell me how many orthographic words morphological words lexical words and semantic words.
Lexical.
In this in this list. هيك بدي يكون الكلام. وبدك يا يعني you can do it in your draft notebook وترسم الكلام كالتالي. جدول بسيط. جدول بسيط. وعاوز ان تفلت اول. How many orthographic words are there? How many morphological words are there? How many lexical words are there? And how many semantic words are there? According to what we have discussed. حسب او بناء ما تعلمناه او ما تناقشناه. يجايز ما يعجبش بعض الناس لكن شوف within this يعني discussion or stop. One minute to do it in your draft notebook. مش صعب هذا. It's not difficult. Make, makes, making, made, maiden. عشان توصل الفكرة تبع الموضوع الأخير هذا خلينا نشوف ال your answers. Then let's check your answers.
Okay.
Orthographically speaking, how many do we have? How many?
Five.
Yes,
nine.
We have five.
Five. Yes,
we have
five. Orthographically.
Also five.
Five.
Yeah.
Lexically.
Three.
No. Just one.
Lexically, listen to my bad.
Two. Lexically.
If you says the first four words,
I am
from the same. Yeah.
Belong to one lexeme. The first four words belong to one lexeme. Make. And the last one. Is a different lexeme.
It's a she, meaning it's a female
she. Two lexical words. And in terms of meaning, semantically, each of them has its meaning. So we have five. I could job كالتالي. I could job كالتالي. Is an in this list. In this list. Come on. So five orthographic words. Lesha Doctor, we have each word written with a space on either side. Morphologically, form each has its form. Lexical words, we're gonna lexeme. The first four words. Belong to this umbrella, make M-A-K-E, capital letter, lexeme. Maiden is a different lexeme. Now, semantically, according to the material, each of these has its meaning. Make is different from makes. ليس هذه لها معنى يا أخوان. Making has different meaning, and made has different meaning, and maiden has, so each of them has its components of meaning. تمام؟
سؤال ممكن؟
سؤال فضلي.
Can't we say that making has two morphemes, make and ing, as inflectional morphemes?
Yes, I thought same way.
تمام رائع سؤالك رائع.
Can I answer it?
تمام. لا لا كان. as one word with this concept of
for my answer.
لو انت لا اسمعني بس خلينا اجاوب على سؤالها عشان ديك الوقت لان if you go back to the material حسب تعريف ماذا نعني morphological word بنختلف بتختلف عن how to analyze it into morphemes. سؤالك رائع لكن حسب within now this material morphological word as approach means as an approach means the form of the word. The form of the word. وطبعا it's one word. Making is one word.
Got it? Yes.
لو الآن من صعب الكلام وحنيجي للكلام قدام made كلمة made. How many morphemes are there in the word made? two. A different form. Now made is made plus simple past morpheme or past participle morpheme. Like for example, the word went. The word went has two morphemes.
Yeah.
Went has two morphemes. Go and the simple past morpheme.
It's called animal.
مثال آخر من من how many morphemes are there in men؟ خلينا نكتب هنا في ال word file.
Two morphemes.
We have noun, the singular noun, man,
man plus and
the plural morpheme. So, two morphemes.
We call it allomorpheme.
لا, هنشوف بعدين. And two morphemes, man plus pluralization. Plural morpheme. هتقول كيف؟ في حاجة هنعرفها اسمها ablouting. قدام إن شاء الله. Later we are going to discuss this process of ablouting and suppletion and so on.
But it's already found in the assignment.
تمام. So now these four, the first four words belong to now this lexeme make and made in is. Now your homework.
Excuse me, doctor.
سؤال.
Can we say that taken has three morphemes? The present and the past participle.
No. Two morphemes.
Two morphemes.
Taken. ما هيش عبارة عن إيش؟ ما هيش عبارة عن أنا خطأ الكلام. Take plus. So we have it's two morphemes.
Plus
this en or the last form. Tamam?
Okay, doctor.
لأن your homework. يا ريت الآن.
دكتور. أنا حبعد. Before you finish.
لو سمحت. لو سمحت. لأن أنا حبعد. إن شاء الله link to the lecture. YouTube link. ولكن. خلينا نصور بالجوال تبعك او تبعك السلايد هذا your homework والنقش المره الجايه هرجع لسؤالك معلش سامحيني لكن الان يعني you need to do this at home as like activity ونفس فكره اللي عملناه نفس الفكره هذه الان هيك نعمل وين وجدول لكل قائمة من الكلمات تمام؟ We have four lists of words where عاوز اغششك واغششك اساعدك في نمبر 2 عشان برضو نوفر وقت لو سأل how many lexemes are there in
one.
هذا الكلام بدنا نصوبه الآن يا جماعة الكلمة taking
taking اسم
اها لان في عندنا يا اخوان ing في عندنا er as what as
what
as bound morphine
bound morphine
هنعرف اكيد معظمكم بيعرف لكن هنزيد معرفه ان شاء الله sometimes two different morphemes share the same form
especially when it is in a flexional morpheme
now ing and er are morphemes that maybe for example er can be inflectional
derivational
and can be derivational and can be
as inflectional doctor it comes with adjectives like I'll just speak bigger and like if derivational it comes with
يا ريت بس يا عباد لما اديك الفرصه لو سمحت
it can be suffix doctor
so suffix as both are suffixes نقول مثلا فولر and eg
teacher
got it so we have
yes clear
Now the word takings they are morphemes, صحيح ing لكن the ing can be inflectional
or derivational can I simplify
and can be derivational what page
can I simplify it if it is preceded by a helping verb like is eating here it is inflectional but if it is preceded it is come along like eating is good thing okay eating here ing is derivational
so when it is for example gerundive making a gerund as a noun it's not inflectional إذا لو رجعنا للسلايد هنا taking the last one takings has ing as what as a derivational morpheme like belongings ممتلكات takings readings قراءة شرقة so we can suppose that ing as derivational so be careful when you do this exercise الطالبة لو وقفتها وكانت بدها تسأل. If you still have a question, please let me know. الناس اللي يعني ما صورتش السلايد يا ريت تصور السلايد. السلايد هذا أو كمان مرة. That's it. So, four lists of words to categorize them into the number of their words. So, whether we have now. تمام حد عنده سؤال تفضل يا اللي بدها تسال مش غلط نكون بطلنا نسال لانه وضحت الفكره so it's fine أنا معايا ضايل ربع ساعة للمحاضرة. We have only 15 minutes. وما ناقشناش حاجة كتيرة يا أبو أحمد. وأنت الآن بتسوف أو بتضيع الوقت. لا لا، أنا مبسوط باللي صار وأنا يعني فرحان بيكم. So please, as we said before, we have quality and we have quantity. واللي ناقشنا اليوم كان رائع. And your discussion, your participation in the discussion enriched our lecture. Any question? هنعمل في ربع ساعة يمكن الفايل الأول بيكفي والفايل الثاني أعتبره زي يعني not to include in our syllabus as like exams. سهل القراءة فايل 2 اللي هو بتاع لكسيكوغرافي لكسيكولوجي، لكن أنا عاوز أركز في ربع ساعة الضايلة على يعني on the first file definitions وإنه بعض المفاهيم المهمة. لكن يعني لو إحنا اضطرينا نتوقف في المحاضرة ونكمل المرة الجاية I would send you more files for يعني coming lectures. بالمناسبة this second this fourth file اللي أنا أعطيتكم إياه as homework as an assignment to summarize the chapter حيوصل لي الواجب تبعك يوم أو تبعك يوم الخميس. هذا الواجب في سلايد not to submit، مش مطلوب تبعت لي إياه. So not to submit to do and we are gonna check your answer later إن شاء الله next class on Sunday. But the homework to submit or the assignment to submit the summary of the chapter summary due 1 p.m. Thursday October 1st. والكلام واضح والتعليمات يعني ما ظنيش يعني حد ما فهمهاش. So 1st of October 1 p.m. within the guidelines given 600 to 700 words. Now
okay, Dr.
I'll send you more files for later classes. Tafaddal.
About the assignment, you said that you needed single spaced.
Single space. طبعا بكره ان شاء الله تعمل ريسيرش كثير ورساله الدكتوراه ان شاء الله وتصير زمان دكاتره معنا في الجامعات او ما بعدنا ان شاء الله. العمر الطويل لنا ولكم والصحه ان شاء الله. So we may have a double space or space and a half ومش صعب تتعامل الكلام هذا، لكن مره ثانيه follow instructions والمارجنز مارجنز كان كاتب 1 انش ومفسرها 2.5 سنتيمتر هذا الوضع يا انش 2 سنتيمتر ونص على اليمين وعلى الشمال وفوق وتحت ولازم نلتزم بالتعليمات. اي سؤال اخر
الدكتور حسن
تفضل.
I have a question about the assignment. You tell us in the instructions that it must be between 600 words to 700 words. If and from two pages to three pages. If it is three pages, but it take from me 996 words. Is it acceptable?
حتخسر درجات.
So it's maximum.
إذا معنيين بالدرجات، برضو مش غلط. يعني يهتم بالدرجات. We need to follow instructions to have the full mark or almost the full mark. عشان نلتزم التعليمات، عشان نأخذ علامة السؤال أو التمرين أو الواجب. مش أقل من 600 ومش أكثر من 700. وضع الكلام إذا نرجع وقص ونبعد سيبك من الكلام. شكرا سؤالك الرائع.
عفوا دكتور.
سؤال آخر على السريع، الناس اللي معها الفايل رقم واحد اللي هو عبارة عن تسع صفحات. طبعا هذا مقدمة لكتاب semantics for translation ولا شيء، وممكن تدور عليه تاخده كامل من الانترنت، لكن it has some nice terminology وممكن تختلف مع الكاتب في بعض المفاهيم والتعريفات، لكن مش غلط. يعني نقرا ونستفيد.
Yes, very easy and condensed definition.
المفروض كل واحد فيكم يعرف من الان فصاعدا what's the difference between to know a language and to be a linguist.
Yes, دكتور.
سامحوني تمديق الوقت، السلايد هتكون موجوده في جوه الريكوردينج في تسجيل الفيديو، وممكن تاخذوها ك يعني نوتس، لكن برضو يعني تفاصيلها عندك وعندك. The details are in the file you got. So please, you need to know. ممكن الان تسال في كويز ولا في امتحان ولا في سؤال صغير what's the difference between knowledge of linguistics and knowledge of a language. واكيد the difference between to be a linguist and to know a language, to use a language, to speak a language, and so you know what we mean by now knowing a language and knowing and being a linguistics specialist or student of linguistics or expert of linguistics or a linguist. تمام؟ فأكيد بتعرف linguistics is the scientific study of language. وطبعا ممكن تكتشف انه it's not necessary to speak a language in order to be a linguist. مش غريب. وهتعرف بكرة تمارين في المورفولوجي Turkish language ولا Scottish language or Japanese language. We can analyze, linguistically speaking, we can analyze a language in terms of linguistics without being able to speak the language. Many linguists don't speak the language they study or analyze. Just analyze, so speak the language they analyze. So ممكن أنا بعترفش, I don't speak French. But we can study French within linguistics areas. It's morphology, it's syntax, the word order of a sentence, and so on. You can do that without being able to speak French and so on. Now, the difference between a linguist and bilingual or multilingual, وأظن الكلام يعني له علاقة بالنقطة الفوق. So the first one. So some linguists are bilinguals or multilinguals, but not all of them. So some linguists are only just speakers of one language. So a linguist of Arabic and speaking just Arabic. عالم في اللسانيات في اللغة العربية ولا يتكلم إلا العربية. Not necessarily to be a bilingual. But many are. Many linguists are bilingual. And some of them are multilingual. They are polyglots. But again, a polyglot is a speaker of different languages. But not necessarily to be a linguist. So again, there is difference between a linguist and a bilingual or a multilingual or a polyglot. وأكيد وصلت الرسالة والفكرة. Now the different approaches, the formal approaches to language, the formal linguistics approaches. We have traditional, we have structural, and we have generative. موجود في الملزمة أو في الملف اللي بعدنا. وأكيد تفاصيله مش صعبة تقرأ وتفهم وتكون أنت مسؤول عنها بعد الآن. واللازم يعني مش مطلوب منك انا امدح لك باسماء واشخاص، بس انت بكره عالم لغه وعالم لسانيات واستاذ في جامعه، مش غلط تعرف اسماء فرديناند ساسور ونوام تشومسكي ليونارد بلومفيلد، زي من الناس اللي بيعرفوا ادب الانجليزي شكسبير، عيب يعني عليه يطلع من بكالوريوس اداب لغه انجليزيه وما يعرفش شكسبير، وعيب عليك تكون يعني سامحني بكلمة عبي it's not good, it's bad to finish a master's program in linguistics without knowing Noam Chomsky or some other pioneers of linguistics, sociolinguists like Labov, William Labov, and so on. أنا مش همتحك همتحك في الأسماء هذه ولكن بنصح وال وال والعلم واسع وقتك الله يبارك لك فيه ويبارك لك فيه وتستفيد منه وممكن تكون أفضل مني وأحسن مني وأعلى مني. Formal linguistics حسب ما هو موجود في الملزمة هذه five areas. لو أنا اطلعت على السلايد هذا وأنا شفته قبل كده you have this slide in the previous lecture. لكن أنا شايف هنا you can see that there are six areas of linguistics. But one of them is not a formal area of linguistics. Or is
phonology?
Not, which one?
Phonology?
No.
Pragmatics is concerned with subdivision of social linguistics.
Because we talk about now forms, structure. Now phonetics, the form of phonemes. Phonology, the combination of forms of phonemes. Morphology, form, syntax, form. So forms. But when we talk about pragmatics has to do with.
We're talking about the context.
We talk about now intended
meaning.
So we have it as under now as a field of functional linguistics, not formal linguistics. So because we talk about now the use of the utterance within context, the function of the utterance, and you can now see the difference. We are running out of time. Unfortunately, اللي ضايل معانا تقريبا خمس دقائق يا أبو أحمد. وصلت الرسالة. So pragmatics is not an area of formal linguistics. تفضل اللي بده يسأل بس يعني على السريع. ويعني الإجابات موجودة في الملزمة لضيق الوقت أنا أضطر أنتقل للسلايد اللي وراه. Signifiers and signifieds. ممكن لأول مرة نمرن الكلام هذا. موجود الكلام تفصيل والناس اللي بدهاش تقرأ تقريش. وحتنجح وتتخرج بالماجستير وناكل الشوكولاته والكيكه تبعتك وان شاء الله بقى. لكن في ناس حاملين شهادات وفي ناس الشهادات حملاهم. اختار. عاوزينك مليان علم من شهاده مش ورقه كده كرتونه. signifiers, symbols, signs, words, phrases, signified these forms. Sorry, the meanings. إذن what it means, what it refers to. إذن المصطلح, the word.
What they stand for.
Is a signifier. Excellent. What it represents, what it stands for, and so on. ناخذ بالنا من الكلام والتفصيل تبعه وابحث.
عربية الدال والمدلول عليه دكتور.
بالضبط رائع. الداء في حاجة اسمها المدلول عليه والداء. أوكي. Now ممكن تلاقي الكلام في الملزمة. ممكن برا الملزمة تفصيله عندك في مراجع أخرى في قاموس لكن أنا اللي حمتحنك فيه الملازم والشغل اللي بنشتغل فيه. Two major divisions within the field of sociolinguistics موجود عندنا language variation واللي لها علاقات زي relationship between linguistic and non-linguistic factors وطبعا هتلاقي non-linguistic factors like age, gender, education, occupation or profession and so on, social class, وهكذا. These are non-verbal or non-linguistic. Now, the second division is language and social interaction. والملزمة بتقول three areas. Pragmatics, discourse analysis, and ethnography of communication or ethnography of speaking حسب الملزمة ما بتقول.
وفي أنا ethnography I have a problem with understanding ethnography.
سؤالك وأنا ما ولا كان عندي مشكلة ethnography of communication تتكلم على culture and beliefs of the people in the community that we are studying. وصلت الفكرة؟ لو احنا بدنا نعمل ethnography study بدنا دراسة ethnography هنشوف الناس اللي في المكان الفلاني ثقافتهم ما معتقداتهم وهكذا. This is what we mean by ethnography or ethnographic study or ethnographic ethnography of communication. تفاصيله موجود في مكان آخر وممكن أرجع بتفاصيله وأعيد الكلام كله في المحاضرة الجاية إن لزم الأمر. بس عشان نخلص السلايد والآن ايديولكت and dialect وموجود الكلام هذا في حاجة في يعني اللهجة الفردية. أنا بتكلم عربي الآن. ايديولكت every person every speaker has he his or her ايديولكت بمعنى ما يشكلك من عوامل كثيرة كمتكلم في اللغة. Your age, your gender, your you as a speaker of language has an ideology that is different from your sister or from your teacher or from your father and or grandfather and so on. Dialect is now the variety of the language either in a region or in a class and so on. We have social dialect or regional dialect and so on. Now the community has
the different accent of the same language.
There's different accent and different.
في نقطة مهمة. الفرق ما بين dialect and accent.
Accent like British and
all variety. Including its vocabulary items, its let's say structure, its pronunciation and so on. But accent is the pronunciation. في ناس احيانا بتكلم انجليزي بلكنة مصرية او بتكلم انجليزي بلكنة ايطالية. Now speaking English with an Italian accent or an Egyptian accent. زي ما قال له perhaps yes, perhaps no.
Yes, I got it. Yeah,
well, so this is now English within what we have now, Egyptian Arabic. And we have Arab apparatory pronunciation in حاجات اللي ضايلة مش كثيرة أنا بكفي. هذا بيكون عبارة عن آخر سلايد للفايل الأول. أنا تعلم this lecture covered two files in the Moodle. File 1 and file 3, but not file 2. File 1 عملنا فيه يعني أنهينا فيه. File 2 file ما مسكناهوش. File 3 معظم المحاضرة كانت file 3 رغم انها one page. لكن we learned a lot. I think so. We benefited from this little page one page material.
Yes.
Psycholinguistics, language acquisition, verbal processing, imitation hypothesis, innateness, اللي هو universal grammar, Chomsky, وفي ناس إلها لا زالت مش كل الدنيا بتأيد Chomsky في universal grammar. It's just a theory. لا هي قرآن ولا هو الآن كلام يعني حقائق الآن موجودة facts theories وممكن ناس تعارض وناس تأيد. So applied linguistics is a wonderful field. معظم الناس اللي عاملة الآن دراسات theses Applied Linguistics. لو بدي ألخص تعريف بسيط لأبلايد لينغويستكس موجود في الملزمة رقم واحد definitions problem sorry language related problems is an how to solve problems related to language. هذه فكرة Applied Linguistics علم اللغة التطبيقي to apply linguistic knowledge in order to fix problems. وممكن نتكلم على تقويم النطق وهذا مجال رائع. Speech pathologist pathology رغم انه مش موجود في الملزمة. او teaching يتعلم طلاب فلسطينيين بما يزوج ما بين الفا والبا وهكذا. So applied linguistics. نكتفي. أعطيكم العافية. This is enough about today's lecture. I am happy with your participation and attendance. أنا هوقف التسجيل وأستنى أي سؤال خارج المحاضرة اليوم. بكفي كده. الله يعطيكم العافية. Thank you very much. See you in next class on Sunday اللي بيكون تاريخه أكتوبر إن شاء الله. I don't know the date. So next week إن شاء الله. Let's stop the recording, but I'll be available in minutes, inshallah. أنا بوقف التسجيل عشان.